is I'm very interested in your responses to it. I'm going to begin with Tom. Good day, Tom.
Good day, hello.
Good, thanks, Tom. What can you tell us?
I haven't done much research inside the medical marijuana and stuff like that, but in terms of people using it as like a party drug, I know a couple of mates, I don't do it personally, but and that they've used it instead of drinking alcohol, because obviously drinking alcohol, like a large quantity of alcohol, can be quite detrimental to your health. And compared to weed, it doesn't actually impact your body as much.
Okay, so Tom, you're speaking of those people you know who are smoking dope rather than drinking grog because they think it's doing them less harm, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, there's a distinction here though, Tom. There's a distinction between medicinal cannabis and the stuff that you and your friends might smoke. And it's interesting, it's a very anecdotal kind of story, this one, but I'm really keen to see if I can find someone who has managed to get a prescription for medicinal marijuana and whether it's had the impact you hope it would have. You're with Geoff, this is Drive. I'm going to play a bit of Elvis Costello to get us moving along, but then I'm going to come back with your calls. If you'd like to talk to me...
Take a moment to tell Geoff a story.
Epilepsy is one of those areas where there's a great deal of faith and belief that medicinal cannabis can ease the frequency of them. If we've talked before, Michelle, and I do remember it, I think it tells me that this is, what, very cost prohibitive for you?
Absolutely. So we actually currently have a script through our neurologist at PMH.
Yeah.
She is an authorised prescriber.
Yes.
She's a professor of neurology, so you can imagine not much she doesn't know, and she's an epileptologist as well.
Okay.
So we have a script for a product, which I won't mention the brand name just in case, because it's ABC. I can say it if you want, but...
No, that's okay.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, so he'll need several bottles of it per month, but it's $150 for a 25-milliliter bottle.
How much?
$650, we're told by the neurologist.
How quickly would he go through that?
I think I've worked out he could get about 30 doses out of that, so that would last 15 days.
Okay. Have you had access to it yet?
No, we haven't actually had it filled because of the cost.
Okay.
Also, only last week he actually had to have just a 2-day in PMH of what they call a video EEG, and that was for the neurologist to get a baseline of exactly where he's at so that when and if we can afford it, she knows whether the CBD, the medical cannabis, is working or not, because it is so cost prohibitive.
Yeah.
She doesn't want it just to go on hearsay of whether it's working or not. She wants that clinical evidence. So say we started it, 3 months down the track she would do another EEG and be able to compare, because there's not just seizures involved, there's lots of other epileptiform activity and things going on, and which it's meant to help with as well.
Michelle, what do you and your family and your boy need the most out of medicinal cannabis? Do you need confirmation of the benefits that might come with it? Do you need that price to be a whole lot less expensive than it is? Do you need it to be subsidised?
Absolutely. Yeah? It does definitely need to be subsidised. I don't think... My son's only 26 kilos.
Oh, my word.
Yeah, I know he's stunted from all the medicines he's on, all the anti-epileptic medications that inhibit appetite and things. They all have their varying effects, so
sure.
Some will increase and some will decrease appetite, so he's only 26 kilos, so I don't think there's not many families that could afford $650 for one bottle of medicine, because it goes on weight, so the heavier you are, the more you need, like most